Hi everyone, welcome back to RyGurukul.com. In this tutorial, we will be delivering into GUI programming with Python using Tkinter library. Our focus today is on creating radio buttons within a graphical user interface. Radio buttons are a type of GUI, that is graphical user interface elements, used in software applications to provide a user with a way to make a single selections from a list of mutually exclusive options. They are often used when users need to choose one option from a set of choices where only one option can be selected at a time. Example, gender. So gender contains either male, female or transgender. So whenever we are selecting, we are always targeting to select any one gender. Radio buttons are typically displayed as small circles or rounded square with text labels next to them. For building radio buttons, we use Tkinter library. So for doing that, we have used here import Tkinter library for building our complete code. Now after that, this library will be important for using there all those attributes or elements. So I mean, this is required to import the library so that we can use the other attributes related with that. Next options I want to use here, root. So this root options, we are going to call it out equal to tk, and then this is a functions which will use it. After that, we have to define the title. So root dot title, and under this we will provide the title name. So here we'll add radio button sample. So this is the title. The purpose of this main window created using the Tkinter class to define the proper class of Tkinter. For setting the titles of the window using dot title functions, which we have used here, method, I can call it out. And after that, we will define the label, which label we will use it. So for defining the label here, we'll add label. Whatever you will type, you will get and smart suggestions so that you can identify tk dot label, and we'll select this for the label, and after that we'll include root comma text, whichever text we want to provide it, that text should be required. So here we'll add text in double quote, select the option, and then we'll add this, then curly braces, sorry, round bracket will be closed. After that, we will use label dot pack. Here, this will add pad x equal to 25 and pad y equal to 15. This label widget we are using for the label class. This means this label class, we have to set the label text to guide users on what to do. So that's the reason we have added label text here. For pad method to add the label to the window where we are adding pad x and pad y. So pad x and pad y is padding around the label of better spacing. If we will not add this, probably our code will not work. Next options, we want to declare the variable. So for declaring the variable, here we will add selected, and under that we will add options equal to tk dot string var. We are declaring here string var as a tkinter variable. The purpose of the string var class to store the selected options from the radio buttons, which we will use it further if we want. Next options, here we want to define the radio button, how many radio buttons we want. So radio underscore button, we'll add here button 1 equal to tk radio button, tk dot radio button, because this is the options we are getting because we have imported Tkinter library. Otherwise, we will never get these suggestions. Next, I want to add the text. So here I am defining text as mail is the first text I wanted to be there. So mail, I want the first text here, and then after that I will define variable. So next variable will be comma variable equal to selected options. So here we'll add selected option. If the code is right, we will always get this type of smart suggestions, and value I want to define as option 2, which we will use it as a value equal to the option 1 which we have defined here. So we'll add as a male. Now this is done exactly same way we have to write it down for female and transgender. So we'll just change few of the options. So here, it, once it is done, we will close this round bracket and copy and paste it 2-3 times. We'll make the changes for the button 2. We want second button, radio button we have highlighted. Here we'll add female, select option, and then next options I want as female. This is done exactly similar way. I wanted to add here as third option, which will be available for radio button 3, and I want to update the text as transgender. Exactly same text, we'll copy and paste it to value sections so that this will be highlighted. Now let's understand this widget, complete widgets. So radio button widget is using the radio button class. It means this class, I am talking about this class, we will add the text and value for each radio buttons. Variable parameter is used to bind the radio button to the selected options variable. The value parameter assigns a unique value to each radio button. Now next, I want to do the packing. So radio button, all three radio button pack will be added under some packing, so that we will have the pack method to add each radio button to the window. We will also use the anchor parameter to align the radio buttons to the west or left side. And finally, we will close. So here, let me add for all three radio buttons. So radio button 1. And then I want to add the pack here. After that, within that, I will define anchor. So this is the anchor equal to tk dot w. Now this is done. Exactly similar way, we also do it for button 1 and 2. sorry, button 2 and 3. And after that, I will add root dot main loop so that we can have the final output. Now, this purpose of the importance of the main loop method to start the GUI element loop, which keeps the application responsive. So let me run this code and show you the result. After that, we'll see the options. So whenever I'm running, you can see we have added the select options, and here we have the different radio buttons which is available, which we have created as male, female, and transgender. So this is how we can build any GUI framework or any GUI applications using Python Tkinter library. So let's summarize. We have started with the root class, where we have created the title radio button sample, and the label we have defined as select the options. If we did not define the title as radio button sample, we will never get this title available. You can see we have added radio button sample. That's the reason sample is available. Whatever informations we have added in the label, that is available here, and three radio buttons is listed within our code. So that's all about this video or content. Hope you enjoyed this. For more learning or for more advanced learning, try to explore more complex points or more radio button complex topics, which will help you to understand more in terms of Python Tkinter library. And finally, thanks for watching this video. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials. Check out our other videos on Python and GUI programming. See you in the next tutorial. Thank you for watching.